Welcome back to United Tradesman Academy. We have another bender video here where we're going to cover number one, different size of benders. Number two, different size of conduit. Number three, why so many sizes? And number four, just a few code references for the people who are familiar with this information and for the new people that are watching that have a code book. And this will give you some useful information to understand these, some of the things that I'm going to present here today. Not everything, just a little bit. So let's start with number one. Half inch EMT only. This bender is going to be the smallest pipe bender that they make. And this is for a half inch EMT conduit. You will not find a smaller EMT conduit bender than this. This would be the half inch. So if someone tries to play a trick on you, which we used to do to apprentice, we say, hey, go get me that quarter inch bender. Well, they don't make quarter inch pipe, nor do they make a quarter inch bender. So this is going to be the first size, and it goes up from there in small increments. Okay, next size bender, 3/4. 3/4 EMT. Now, on the back of this bender, it's going to go back down to half inch. But half inch, rigid. Not EMT, half inch rigid. So with this bender, you could bend 3/4 EMT, and also you can bend half inch rigid conduit. Your next size bender, Big Bertha right here. No, I'm just joking. This is going to be a 1-inch EMT bender. 1-inch EMT. As you can see, this bender is a little bit weathered. Pretty much the whole entire part of this is rusted, but it still bends the same way. So now, on the back side of it, 3/4 rigid. So you can bend 1-inch EMT conduit with this bender. Also, you can bend 3/4 rigid with this same bender. This is a big bender. So this one here is going to be for 1 1/4 EMT conduit and also 1-inch rigid. Now, this one has an extra little piece on it, even though the other ones have it built in. So this is a two-piece. So you have this one shoe, then you have your footstep. This footstep allows you to put enough pressure on that pipe as you're bending it, so you will not kink the pipe as you're bending it. So this will be a 1 1/4 EMT conduit bender and a 1-inch rigid conduit bender. Let's go on to number two, which is different sizes of conduit. So we have half inch conduit, which is the smallest one. 3/4, which is the next size up from half inch. 1-inch conduit, which is the next size up from 3/4. 1 1/4, which is the next size up from 1-inch. So this half inch bender goes with this half inch pipe. This 3/4 bender goes with the 3/4 pipe. This 1-inch bender goes with the 1-inch pipe. Now, the 1 1/4 pipe It goes with the big heavy one that I set up here. It's orange and gray. You know, the big Bertha, big heavy one. Yeah, that one goes with this one. So, if anybody comes to you on the job site and tells you, hey, go get me that 3/8 piece of pipe. 3/8. Hey, go get me that 3/8 piece of pipe. Don't let them pull their trick on you. Because EMT starts at, or conduit starts at half inch size. 3/8 is below half inch on the ruler or a tape measure. So it's gonna go half inch, 3/4, 1 inch, 1¼, and so on and so forth. Now, why so many sizes? Well, there's several reasons for that. So let's keep this short and simple. So this half inch pipe can only hold so many wires. You may be able to get, let's say you have a hot, a neutral, that's one circuit, a hot and another neutral, that's one circuit. Then you may have a ground wire. Because you can't fill this conduit up to capacity, because then you won't be able to pull the wire through. And also too, there's a rule in the code that you can't fill that conduit all the way up. So now you only can get 4 wires in this conduit. That's just hypothetically speaking. That's not what the code says. I'm just giving you an example. So now for this next 3/4 conduit, you can get more than 4 of those same size wires in this pipe because it's a larger size inner diameter. So let's go 1, 2. That's one circuit. 1, 2. That's another circuit. 1, 2. That's 3 circuits. 6 wires. 1, 2. That's 8 wires now, and a ground wire. 1 ground. So now you have 9 wires in this conduit, but in this one you only can get 4 in this conduit. I'm sorry, 5. Now, this is just only for an example. This is not what the code says, that you can get 4 wires and a half inch and 9 wires and 3/4. So for you code heads, this is only to show an example of why you would use different sizes of conduit. Now, take this one step further without confusing the newcomers to the channel, the newcomers to the video, or the newcomers to conduit and wire. You may have some even larger wire. Let's erase this right here. You know what? Let's go over here to the 1 inch. So, and let's go. You have number 12 size wire. You have number 10. You have number 8. Now, this may seem funny at first, but number 12, you would think it'd be bigger because it's a bigger size. But actually, it goes the opposite direction. It goes large to small on the electrical scale. So number 12 is smaller than number 10. 10 is smaller than number 8. So 8 is actually going to be the biggest of all of these. So now, if you had a larger wire, you want to use a larger size conduit, because if you're trying to put the same amount of number 8s in this 3/4, that it won't fit. So you would have to upsize to the next size, or maybe even the next size conduit. Okay, so let's move on to the next point. Time out. Thank y'all if y'all made it this far through the video. Hey, comment, like, subscribe. Let me know if you would like to see more of the electrical theory part of the National Electric Code. Because a lot of times the actual book gets people confused. You can actually do the physical labor, but this portion of the work, it can kind of get confusing. So, last but not least, we have NEC code references. This is just pertaining to what we talked about today. If you want to do a little bit more further reading, you can go to Google, or if you have a code book, let me back up. If you don't have a code book, type in NEC chapter 9, and you can begin to read and understand some of the things that I shared with you today. So chapter 9 is going to let you know what NXC is about. And also, too, it's going to let you know what tables 4 and 5 and the nipple feel 60%. So in table 4, it's going to have every piece of conduit you can imagine. So what I mean by that is you have what we talked about today. And what you see on the bender here, it says EMT, that's electric metallic tubing. So you have EMT, which is going to be in table 4. You have rigid conduit. All these have different sizes, different specs. And if you look at table 4 in NXC, it'll tell you everything about that type of pipe. Now we have a lot of more types of pipes. So to begin to get familiar with these different types and to do these calculations when you're taking a test, you need to look at table 4. Table 5 is going to talk about the wire size, the dimension of the different sizes of wire. You have number 12, you have 10, you have 8. In table 5, it's going to talk to you about the different dimensions of these. The surface area, I don't want to go too far because I don't want to get ahead of myself and confuse you even further, but that's why I put reference, because it's just a reference right now. Thank you for watching this video to the entirety. Look, comment, like, subscribe. Let me know what you think of the video. If you say, psh, no, I don't need that, let me know. But if you do need more of these type of videos to get the theory part, so when you do go take your test, you'll be somewhat prepared, or you'll be more prepared with more information I'm going to be bringing. This is just a small percentage of what this channel is about. So look, one other thing too, before I let you go, I'm going to be a featured guest on WWHVAC's channel. I'm actually a subscriber to him. He's an HVAC contractor, and he's taught me many things in my journey to learning how to diagnose HVAC units, how to do new installs on HVAC units. So we'll be doing a broadcast or a podcast, which will be Sunday night at 6 p.m. If you want to see the video that he put together, go to my community post, and it's right at the top. Please click the like button on that and hit the notification, so when we do start the podcast Sunday night, you'll get notified. He will have more presenters on there, not just me, so I won't be the only one talking. But if you want to learn different ways to start your business, different ways to become a contractor, different ways to study how to pass your test, or just how to be better in the field that you're in, come on out. Come on out. Spend some time with us. You know, drop some likes, drop some comments. We'd love to hear from y'all. We'd love to answer your questions. That's what this is about. That's why I'm doing this. That's why he's doing this. So look, we'll see you next time back at United Tradesman Academy.